I've had several requests to give an overview of how to configure a HART device using a handheld programmer. So in the next few minutes, I'll show you how to correctly wire a HART device on the bench, connect to handheld, and access the configuration options. I'll also explain some of the different terms you'll hear and show you an alternative option to a handheld. Let's get started. This is what you'll need: a HART device, a 24-volt DC power supply, a HART handheld programmer, a multimeter, and most importantly, a 250-ohm resistor. Now, if you're making a scrunchy face about the resistor, let me show you why you need this. Most HART devices are loop powered, meaning they get power from the PLC card they're connected to. The PLC input essentially has a power supply and some input impedance built in, normally around 250 ohms. If you remember from one of my previous videos, the HART signal is superimposed onto a 4 to 20 milliamp signal and is actually a small AC voltage. If you're familiar with basic electronics, you know that you have to measure the voltage across a resistor. Now let's wire this up and see what we get. All set. I've created a loop with the HART device, power supply, and load resistor. And I have my trusty multimeter in the loop so we can monitor the loop current. Now that our loop is working, we can connect our handheld programmer across the resistor. But before I start programming, let me explain a little bit about handhelds. When you buy one of these, it will be delivered with a library of device descriptors, or DDs, already loaded. Every HART device has a unique DD file that contains the menus, fields, or wizards that are needed to configure the device. So when a new device is released to the market, you will need to update the library on your handheld with the DD for that new device. Occasionally, a device may also be updated with new functionality that requires a new or updated DD, so you might have to update your handheld then too. But in the instance you don't have the correct DD for your device, don't fret, as there is a generic DD that allows you to do basic configuration for any device. Okay, so now we want to tell the handheld to look for connected devices, so it will start scanning each HART address. When it finds a device, it will pull up the correct DD and we're off. Now keep in mind that HART communicates at only 1200 baud, so don't be surprised when it takes a few seconds to load. Now the DD for the device is loaded, and in this case we're connected to a radar level gauge. We can see the process variable is displayed. If we go into the configuration menus, we can access basic setup parameters. For instance, we can choose the media type, whether we are measuring a liquid or a solid. We can also select the tank shape and calibrate empty and full levels. In the extended configuration menu, we can set up output signal damping and parameters for preventing false readings. So, device configuration using a handheld is relatively straightforward. However, a handheld is a pretty expensive piece of equipment, clocking in at about $8,000. Now, if you're suffering from sticker shock, it's because the handheld is approved for use in hazardous areas and must be intrinsically safe. Just ask my friend here. Another option for benchtop configuration is a USB modem. This cost-effective device, along with my laptop, can do the same functions as a handheld. So this software package uses the same type of DD library as the handheld. And here you can see the options look identical to what's accessed using the handheld. So that's it. Configuring a HART device with a handheld or USB modem is pretty simple. Just remember, the number one thing that people forget is that little 250 ohm resistor. Want to learn more about HART? Check out our other videos that are linked in the description below. If you liked what you saw, smash that like button and share it with a colleague. And let me know if you want to see something else. My contact information is also in the description. Until next time.